your god. You think you could just make up stuff? Play with...
Hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
I don't like the controls in this game. Well, the controls are very fucked up in this game.
Oh, no.
I don't like it at all.
Thank you.
are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there. You must go into the light. A deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I beam. To its ports I beam. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light. Protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light. Pick up the flashlight, turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun. Pick up the revolver. He is your enemy, and you need to defend yourself.
Okay, so I gotta get to the lighthouse. Hang on, I don't like how these controls are. Yeah, I can't play inverted. It screws me all up. That's better.
You made me this way, and now I'm gonna kill you.
this up forever.
Okay, we made it to the lighthouse.
Ellen,
wake up.
Baby, just another nightmare.
Welcome to Bright Falls. Oh, we're on a ferry boat.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Okay.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear.
Oh, nice seaplane right there.
Hi.
Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Mead, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I can get an interview?
Look, Mr. Mead, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be cheap. Not a hard man to track.
And the graphics aren't horrible.
I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Not great, but not horrible. Nice fishing boat. Mountains. It's like a police boat over there.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got in.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge.
Oh, they're putting up Christmas decorations or taking them down.
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. I'm just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you, too.
Nice Chevy truck sitting
here.
Right here.
Come on, let's get back to the car.
Well, which car is ours.
Come on, Slowpoke. You get the full service here. I've made all the arrangements. I drive the car. I'll even carry the bag.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
Carl Stuckey.
I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
I can't believe it. I've got all your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they get out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Right. So much for a quiet vacation.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Are you staying long, Mr. Wake? I can't believe it. I'm having a conversation with Alan Wake.
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox.
Nice biker jacket.
I do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah. You need to give it a good shot.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stuckey, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
Cauldron Lake is a special place, very inspiring.
Nothing creepy going on here.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed, and then I must...
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
It's kind of creepy.
Splendid, splendid! Damn, burn it.
The Andersons, they're, local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Well, they look like bikers.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Mission accomplished.
Oh, look at this nice little diver's
it's
island.
Gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Where'd we
Alice
park
had a phobia. At? The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Where did we park? Way up there?
Are you sure you read the directions right? It's nothing like in the brochure. It said near the lake, not on it.
It's on the lake. In the lake. Bird Leg Cabin. Hey, look at the view. Gotta explore. I find the door. Clearly, that's a generator in there.
Here we go. Let's take a look inside.
It's dark in there. We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the power on, honey?
Get the power on, okay.
Hello? Anyone here?
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Look at this hunk of junk.
Once been the site for a love story. It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, and forget about my work.
Will he forget about his work? Will he?
I could be happy here. It would be bad again.
Okay, return to Alice. Okay. I can live out here like this. Surrounded by nature.
Alice? Honey? Well, hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Okay.
I thought we were going to get some there for a minute.
Surprise!
Alice? The cabin had gone dark. All the lights were out.
Alice! Alice! Where are you? Help!
Alice, I'm coming! It's all right, I'm coming!
What the hell?
No! No!
Maybe I shouldn't have skipped that. Is that her, though?
Keep going, Alan. Wake up.
Alice?
How'd he end up in his car?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot. Station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Okay, well, we can't jump off. Was our car.
Hello? Hello? Is someone there?
It's almost like he's in his own book.
Blue sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
You!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help. Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Nightfall!
Oh, hell.
Carl Stucky.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
Holy hell.
Way out of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
Here's Johnny. Okay, we got a flashlight.
During your...
Mr. Your...
Trying...
Yes.
Great Falls Sheriff's Station. Help me out.
Hello,
Roman. Let you.
Just killed someone or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick. The Dark Forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
It's rabbit season.
I saw the river below. Something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across.
Why doesn't he walk across that ledge? I didn't even want to look at the water. Where the fuck do I go from here? Okay, now where? The brightness needs to be up on this game just a little fucking bit. Okay, that's much better.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water. Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
I have no idea if I'm even going the right fucking way.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way. Forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top.
Okay, here we go. God damn it. Come on, biker, jump.
was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather's absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear as day. An old man like me, wish I could just roam wild.
I thought maybe I had a map.
But here I am, and I'll keep you company all night long if I want. God, it looks like I'm not the only one.
Apparently, I don't.
Hello, Maurice. What are you looking at? Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Okay, we're getting closer.
The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Okay, we're getting somewhere little by little. God damn it. Holy shit.
bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate
in the Twilight Zone.
Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among
them. Ooh, we got a shotgun.
But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. Night Springs. Tonight's episode.
On the Twilight Zone. Suicide. Fuck, I'm dead.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reached
about time that fucking door opened.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself. The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now. The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
All right. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness.
can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix her. I'll bring her back. The story
do, 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 do. Wake
up. Great ball, Sheriff Station.
Thank God a sheriff finally showed up.
Oh, thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
I would say he did, yeah.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
Yeah, he did.
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
She did, or he did. Such a weird game. I mean, it is such a weird game.
They call the Sandman. Tiptoes to my room every night. And just a sprinkle of stardust and a whisper. Go to sleep. Everything is all right.
Right.
I close my eyes. Then I drift away.
End of episode one.
Previously on Alan Wake. I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up on
New York City 3 years ago.
Honey, I'm home.
Back here, sweetie. How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
Coffee's on.
Great, thanks. I'll need it if I'm gonna finish this by tomorrow.
Looks like a typical New York winter. Snowing like crazy.
Oh, hey, I just finished those cover mock-ups. They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
No kidding. I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
Okay, we got a nice bathroom. We have a dryer, but not a washer. Looks like a typical GTA bathroom. Here's our bedroom. Closet, no clothes hanging.
These look really good.
Oh, sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body.
Return to Slender.
The last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called. Alan! Alan!
I'm right here.
Check the fuse box.
I'm right here. I'm on it, honey.
Why are you screaming?
Hurry.
I'm right here, baby.
I'm fine. Just.
You're screaming like I'm outside.
Please.
fuse box is probably in the bathroom.
I really don't like this, Ellen. Please hurry. Ellen, I really need those lights on.
Calm down, lady.
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Okay.
Hi.
You okay?
I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
I know it's stupid, but it's just... especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
It's just a power outage.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay.
Nothing to concern about.
I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch.
Well then, Mr. Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me. I'll let you get on with it then. Sarah, Sheriff Breaker, is waiting for you. She's very good at her job.
Nice fish.
I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time.
Doc Nelson was the image of a small town doctor. Sheriff Breaker had called him to the station to take a look at the cut in my head.
Your phone's on the desk. The battery was dead.
Hang on, I want to look around first.
Have a nice day now. Very good. I'll come back later on to remind you, just in case.
Oh, there's that old creepy lady again.
Mr. Wake, the sheriff is waiting for you in her office down the corridor. That was Cynthia Weaver. I guess you can call her the town eccentric. She used to be the editor of the local newspaper, but she's focused on, other things these days.
Yeah, it's, Mulligan here. I'm at Stuckey's gas station with Thornton. There's no sign of him, over.
Wait. Yeah, this is Thornton. Look, we've located the brake float. It's here. That's some good news, right? Stuckey was supposed to be driving it at the rehearsal.
The sheriff wants to see you in her office, Mr. Wake.
Your phone, Mr. Wake?
Thank you.
Have you started looking for my wife yet?
My men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
I'm not sure. I can't remember. We were arguing. I walked out of the cabin.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake?
Yes.
How did you end up at Stuckey's gas station?
I wanted to tell her what had happened last night, but I couldn't. She'd lock me up.
Beep,
excuse
beep.
Me. I need to take this. Hello?
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
Stop talking to the law. You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife.
Who is this?
Go to the back lot. There's a hole in the fence on the left. Look inside the junker. I left a little something there to convince you we're all on the same page here. After you ditch the cops, you're going to meet me in Elderwood National Park. There's a spot called Lover's Peak. Midnight.
Mr. Wake, can I do anything?
Stupid pal. We're watching you.
I need to get some air. The sheriff said I could go out back.
I couldn't go anywhere yet.
Mr. Wake,
I had to play along with the caller. Alice's life was at stake.
Just don't find Walter in there. He's one of our regulars.
I thought he quit drinking for good.
Hey, mister! Hey, you turn the light. The light's on!
The deputies, they don't understand. They won't listen to me. I need it to be bright in here. Hey!
The early morning light hurt my eyes and made my head ache. The man on the phone had said, go through the fence on the left.
I don't see no hole in the fence.
The caller had told me to find a hole in the fence behind the police station. There was something for me in an abandoned car.
Okay, but there's no hole in the fence. Can't jump over that.
Alice's driver's license had been placed on the front seat. The caller meant business.
Barry?
Very nice old truck.
I flew out yesterday. I'm here in Bright Falls.
Barry, listen to me. I'm at the sheriff's station. Come and get me. I can't talk now.
Al, what the hell is going on?
I had to get the sheriff to let me go. I needed to get to Elderwood National Park to meet Alice's kidnappers.
Here we go.
A writer is a light that reveals the world of his story from darkness, shapes it from nothingness, the way a sculptor...
Marvelous, Sarah. I just wanted to settle all the damage the Anderson brothers might have inadvertently caused on their recent...
Are you happy, dude? The lights are on.
They are not accountable for their actions, of course. I can assure you that my staff has been reprimanded.
Tor and Odin never caused any trouble to anyone when they were still living at the...
Are you feeling any better, Mr. Wake?
I'd like to leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about...
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches. The cabins at Elderwood are pretty nice, though.
That sounds perfect.
I'm Dr. Neil Hartman. I'd like to invite you to stay at Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Did you talk to my wife?
I had the pleasure of discussing your situation with her on several occasions.
Did you set something up with her?
I invited her here. My clinic is a place where...
Oh, hey! Oh, my!
Take it easy.
Hey, nobody move! Get your hands off of my client!
Who are you?
I'm Barry Wheeler, his agent. If you have business with Mr. Wake, you talk...
I had to talk to someone. I told Barry everything. He thought I was certifiable.
But it's weird that he's narrating his own story.
The fact that I'd written something, even if I couldn't remember it, was enough for him. He smelled money. And he believed that Alice had been kidnapped. Anything beyond that was another story. I had a midnight appointment with the kidnapper in a place called Lover's Peak, somewhere in Elderwood National Park. The plan was to rent a cabin.
I don't like it, Al. I don't like any of it. It's not good. In fact, it's the absolute opposite of good.
Mr. Wake! Barry, you found him!
Hi, Rose.
Nice looking. Wow. Kind of looks like a Hummer.
I was thinking about you, too.
Great.
I was just bringing Rusty some coffee. He's on the balcony, looking after Max. Poor thing.
What an airhead.
Gee, Mr. Takes a Swing, buddy. This is not her fault. She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan. She even has a fan site dedicated to you. And she was very helpful when I was looking for you. Seriously, Al, what you were saying in the car? Just listen to yourself. What, you shot a
guy here.
And his body just disappeared?
Easy there, boy. I'm almost done.
Hey, Rusty, right? You rent cabins.
Oh, Mr. Wake. I'd shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay, sure.
When was the last time you slept? What, are you high? Have you been drinking?
No! Look, Barry, I'm missing a week. And someone's got Alice.
Do you
and
understand
just...
what it sounds like when you say stuff like that? Don't get me wrong, it's a good story. Could be a bestseller. But when you start confusing fiction with reality, you're buying yourself a ticket to the funny farm.
Hey, here.
Al, you can't just go and meet a kidnapper. Those situations always end up in disaster.
I think this is the form you wanted.
And here are the keys.
Okay, you're all set, Mr. Wake. Glad to have you staying here.
Thanks. Can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Oh, sure. It's at the end of the nature trail. Just follow the paths, you'll get to it eventually. It's an easy walk.
You'll get to it eventually.
If you have any trouble finding it, just keep your eyes on the radio mast. It's right below that.
You gotta talk to the cops.
She's my wife, and it's my call. Can we talk about this later?
No. This whole thing... Listen, you hit your
head. Nice woolly mammoth right here.
Ow, come on. You gotta understand how crazy all this sounds.
All right, here we go.
That's just crazy talk, Al. Al? Al? We should go to the sheriff or call the FBI?
Damn it, Barry. This is not a goddamn debate, Barry.
Just be careful with the natives, Al. These yokels are dangerous. Everybody hates a tourist, or it'll be deliverance all over again.
It's a nice looking cabin. Nice fire in the fireplace. I don't get what the coffee thing is for. Nice little cabin in the woods. Head for Lover's Peak.
I'll wait here, Al. I'll hold down the fort. I'll be with you in spirit.
Yeah, you do that.
Barry had the keys to the car he rented. Wasn't a long walk to the visitor center, and it wouldn't be any use to me in the forest. I knew I should have gone to the cops. This wasn't the smartest thing I'd ever done, but I was still angry with Barry for trying to talk me out of it. These people had called me right in the sheriff's station. The cops wouldn't scare them, and they had Alice.
Visitor center. What is this place here? Scared the shit out of me. Just another cabin?
Show folks, as promised, our very own Dot Pinnell has just parked his rear end in the studio. Dot, what is your best plan like?
My plan? You make it sound a lot more organized than I ever seen.
Okay, visitor center this way. I like we can go in other cabins. Moon Moonshine Cave. Can we go in this cabin?
Crime and punishment. The cancer and cure of civilization. But some crimes are impossible to punish.
This ain't good. Like somebody drove right through the building.
Oh, hell. It happened just the way it was on that page. I found came true. It knew.
Whatever did this couldn't be far. Rusty had found a page from the manuscript. It would help me understand what had happened.
Good boy.
All right, get the lights on.
The only way to make sure that Rusty was safe was to get the power running and the lights back on. Someone had destroyed the circuit breaker. There was no way to get the lights back.
Well, they're fucked.
Rusty!
The ground was covered with oily patches that looked like liquid darkness. Something had torn a mammoth-sized hole in the wall.
Please!
Don't feed the animals!
Fishing
is only permitted for those prisoners
who purchase a park. Fishing license. Obey!
Doctor's instructions?
At all times.
Rusty, no!
Two bears and wolves never approach any other closer than pets must be leashed.
Yeah, at all times.
Never leave your pet
unattended.
Holy fuck! I'm out of ammo! Fuck, I'm out of ammo!
Was covered with oily patches that looked like liquid darkness. Something had torn a mammoth-sized hole in the
Please
wall.
Don't feed the animals.
Fishing
is only permitted
for those prisoners. Which is a park.
Fishing.
License. Obey.
Thank you.
Okay, now the gate's open.
Forget about it, Barry. It's just me going crazy.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. You're not crazy. I wish you were crazy, but you're not crazy. Ow, be careful.
Stay in the cabin. Don't open the door for anyone. I mean it.
Lover's Peak was at the far end of the nature trail.
Yeah, it's this way. Oh, I don't have many bullets left. Okay, we're going the right way still. God damn, I don't have enough bullets. Son of a bitch. You asshole. God. I'm out of batteries. Damn it! Son of a bitch! I can't fucking run. Turn the fucking music, driving me nuts. Can't fucking run! Holy fuck. I gotta take a breather right there. Holy cow. You have no button to run fast. It's one speed. And that's all you get. You can't super run nothing. How many bullets? I got 5 bullets left and no flashlights. Let's just stay in the light for a minute. Lover's Peak, we're almost here. Well, great. Now we gotta watch out for fucking bears. Bitch. This is all the faster you can run. You can jump. Motherfucker. Don't stop. Run to the fucking light. How many bullets I got? 6? How do I get in here? Pick it up. Okay. I need a break. Gripping the controller too tight. Okay. Elderwood National Forest in Washington, I'm assuming. An awful long walk to get to Lover's Peak. Like, why couldn't we drive here? Please keep your hands and feet inside the compartment at all times. Going back. Okay.
Come on, we gotta get moving. More of them coming.
Get your flashlight.
It's kid stuff. The flares will keep the bastards away.
Thank you for the flare gun. I'll have to remember that.
You can see them too?
Hell, of course I see them. Come on, we gotta move.
Why?
Because that's the way the story goes.
Yeah, but...
Let's move!
I lost my gun back there.
Oh, I've got a gun. Just keep that light steady on him.
It took a moment, but then I recognized him. He'd been on the ferry when I first arrived here with Alice. He knew my name. We were headed in the direction of Lover's Peak. There was no way this was a coincidence. He was the kidnapper.
Come on, Wake! You better keep up!
Thank you.
No, I ain't got no bullet.
From the emergency box to hold them off while I get these boards off.
Give me the gun.
Yeah, no can do. Are you kidding? Give me the gun. No time for pick off. Hold them off, damn it.
How am I supposed to use the flares? Oh, R1, okay.
Just a little longer. Scare them off. Get some light on those bastards! That'll keep them off us! Just a little longer! I almost got it! Okay, it's open. Move it or lose it.
Move it or lose it.
Soon.
Well, you got the gun. I don't have a gun. Entering Lover's Peak. Follow the kidnapper.
This is it, Wake. The last stand. There's more flares here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming. Give me the goddamn gun! They're coming! That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
I'm out of flares. Oh my god.
Stand. There's more flares here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming. Give me the goddamn gun. They're coming. That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
I'm out of flares.
Oh, that's
my god.
Stan, more players here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming. Give me the goddamn gun. They're coming. That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
Motherfucker! How am I supposed to do this with such a limited fucking supply?
As long as they keep coming. Give me the goddamn gun! They're coming! That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
Motherfucker!
Stan, there's more players here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming. Give me the goddamn gun! They're coming! That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
Thank you.
God, I'm running out of batteries already. A lot of batteries. What the fuck?
Stan, there's more players here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming. Give me the goddamn gun. They're coming.
What the fuck am I supposed to do?
Get with the program, Wake.
I'm lighting one flare at a time. Holy fucking Jesus. That was tough.
I knew you were going to say that. I read it all before. You're a hell of a writer.
Holy cow, that was tough.
You're going to bring about something glorious and terrible once we get you some proper editorial control.
What the hell are you talking about? Where's Alice?
I want the entire manuscript.
You're going to give me the manuscript or you'll be sorry. No! Come back here! I swear I'll kill you if you hurt Alice! Do you hear me? Come back here!
He had Alice, and he wanted the manuscript because he thought it held some magical power. But I had no manuscript to give him. I had to get back to Barry and figure out my next move.
Here we go. Tippy toe across the log. Maybe this is not the way to go. It looks like the way to go, but I don't think it is.
Rusty had warned me of these traps. Hell, I was stuck.
Stupid bear trap. Looking bear traps all over here. Wish it would give you a map so you kind of knew which way you were going. I think I'm about ready to save my game anyway. Drop a flare! You mother. I don't think I can quit to the main menu. I'm going to lose. Thank you. Alright, what time is it? Almost 3 o'clock. Let's hope it saves my game. Oh, it does, okay. Alright guys, short stream today, but we'll be back tomorrow doing another one as we continue this playthrough. Everybody have a great rest of your day, and I will catch you all tomorrow.